This is Joseph Drust, and welcome back to another episode of Ask ZBrush. So we had a question sent in asking, what does the white circle on the crease level slider do? So to start off, I just have ZBrush loaded up, and I just have an example model file here loaded in. And the question is asking about the white circle that is on the crease level slider. So if I navigate to the tool palette here and open up the geometry tab, and then go down to the crease area, you'll see here we have the crease level slider, and on the slider there's this little white circle. And if you click on the circle, it is a button, and you can see it toggles to an open circle or a closed circle. So what is this circle doing inside of ZBrush? So with my model here, I've just taken a cube and I've just removed one of the sides. I've just deleted the faces on the side of that cube. Now I'm going to go to the tool palette over here and go down to display properties, and I'm going to turn on double just so you can see this a little bit better. So this is what I have here. So I just have this cube and one of the faces has been removed. So before we get into what this crease level slider does, let's just first divide this cube up and you can see what happens. So I'm going to rotate the model to the side here like so, maybe something like this. I'm going to go to the geometry tab here and I'm just going to click divide here. Now, as I click divide, you're going to notice that that edge that was over here has now shrunk inward as I divide the model up. So see this a little more clearly. I'm just going to rotate to a horizontal view here, and I'm going to turn off perspective, so I'm in orthographic. And then I have a second subtool in the scene, so I'm going to my subtool palette over here, and I'm going to open this up. So let's go back to the geometry tab here, and I'm just going to undo this. So you can see this is what I had originally. This is the cube with the open area here. And as I click divide, you can see that that edge was here. And now if I've divided, it is now shrunk in. So if you're working on a model that has open edges, you may not want this shrinking to happen. You may want this edge to stay right where it was and then just divide. So to do this, you can use creasing. So with this open edge here, I go to the crease palette here, and I can simply just click the crease button. Now by default, the crease button is going to look at any open edges, and since this is an open edge, it's just going to crease this edge only. And after the creasing has been applied, if you zoom in, you're going to see it's going to give this kind of double line effect to the surface. So now I have creased this edge. So now with this edge creased, if I click divide, you're going to notice that that edge is going to stay in the exact place it was. So if you have a mesh that's split into multiple subtools through the use of, say, slicing, and you want to make sure that no gaps form between where those two subtools connect, you can crease that open edge, and then when you divide up, it's not going to shrink. So as you can see here, if I undo this, my box here with that creased edge, and then if I divide, you can see that edge is not moving. So this white circle here on the crease level slider just determines if that edge is going to stay in place, or if that edge is going to move when the divide happens. So if I come over here and turn this off, and now divide the mesh, you're going to see that this edge is still creased, but now that edge has moved like it did before I applied the crease. So there are times where you may have a creased edge, but you also want it to divide and shrink in like this. So in those cases, you can click this little white circle here on the crease level slider, and it will disable that crease functionality of having that edge being locked. So once again, the crease level white circle here is going to determine if the creased open edge is going to stay in place when it's subdivided, or if it's going to move when it's subdivided. So if you have any other questions related to ZBrush pipelines or processes, please use the hashtag AskZBrush on Twitter. Happy ZBrushing!